We literally have an entire tank here. I'm sorry, but Puny Rebels versus entire tank, the tank always wins.
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Spiffing Brit, and today we're playing Tropico 6. That's right, we're back in this fantastical game. What is this game all about, I hear you say, ladies and gentlemen? Well, it's all about being given your very own island, and you are the fantastic despotic dictator of it. Or as I like to call it, charismatic fun guy who 100% of the polled population said was downright the best ever person to ever live. Thank you, Steve. I'm glad you thought so highly of me. Your family will be returned within the fortnight. Anyway, Tropico 6 is a fantastic game where you are effectively given complete and utter control of a tiny island nation. You can choose what you want to do with it. Most of the time, you're going to be finding yourself creating a glorious workscape with lots of cattle ranches, banana plantations, and you're just going to be exporting all of that stuff off to larger nations for profit. Personally, however, ladies and gentlemen, I don't like the sound of that. That's the way that you're meant to play the game. No. Instead, we're going to be using some exploits to put ourselves in a fantastic situation where we will not be playing the game the way it's intended, and instead be making money via the strangest possible way that I can come up with. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's dive into a brand new game and get on with the wackiness. But first, actually, I'm going to do a Tropico 6 speedrun. Yeah, this sounds great. Let's do a quick speedrun. If you ever want to finish just one of these maps ridiculously quickly, allow me to demonstrate how. Okay, bam. We're going to take the island here. Yeah, this seems great. Let's go for island. And we're going to be giving ourselves 20,000 starting money, hardly anything, 50 starting population. We will be starting in the colonial era. We'll put everything onto the hardest difficulty possible. And there we go. So this is the physically most challenging game you could possibly have. And we'll say we'll win when your treasury hits 2 million, ladies and gentlemen. Quite a tricky task indeed. It should take you quite a while to do it. I'm going to be doing it much, much faster, though. Let's get our fantastic challenge meter up and running. So we have 20,000, we need 2 million. Okay, it's quite the challenge, ladies and gentlemen. How on earth are we going to do it? Well, first, you want to find the most expensive building that we can build. Tanneries cost 6,000, rum distilleries 9,600. I do believe rum distilleries are going to be perfect. Yep, I was right. We need rum distilleries. So what you want to do, pause the game, select your rum distillery, put it literally anywhere on the map, and you're just going to want to plonk one down there and one down there. Immediately you'll see we now have no money. What we now want to do is quite simply bulldoze them. I know we get our 2,000 back. Now we're going to save the game. Make a brand new save game and then just load that same save game. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, we started with 20,000 Tropico Dollaroos. And we're bam. For some reason, we've placed down two rum distilleries, bulldozed them, saved the game, reloaded it, and we now have 39,000 Dollaridoos. We're now going to take that 39,000 and, you guessed it, ladies and gentlemen, place down three rum distilleries. Actually, we can do four. Fantastic. So place down four rum distilleries, build them, get our demolish tool back out there, and demolish them down to the ground. Now it's time to save the game once more and load it up again. Trust me, ladies and gentlemen, this is the fastest way to beat the game by quite a mile. Now we have 96,000. Don't ask me how it just keeps getting more and more. Trust me, it is just science. So more rum distilleries, place them all down. I mean, you can even go into a little bit of debt when placing them if you really want. Wabam. And then just bulldoze them all, get back to 96,000, drop down a save, and load it up again. This game, trust me, it's magical. Mwah. These exploits have been in since day one. I think I've personally found about 5 different exploits with this game, but they just get better and better. I mean, look at it. We have 260,000 now. How many rum distilleries is that? Who knew all it took to become a millionaire in this game was literally just place millions of rum distilleries down? And bam, we are now at 855,000. Technically speaking, you don't actually need to place down more. You theoretically can just drop down another save game. So bam, we can have save number 6 here. And then we just load save number 6. Remember, we have 800,555, and then we load that save up again, and now we suddenly have 1.3 million. So we just drop down yet another save. Honestly, this is some kind of like strange compound interest situation going on in the background. Well, basically what happens is the game has two separate ticks. It has a tick for when you basically place down a building, and that's money going out. And then when you choose to bulldoze it, it ticks again immediately to give you the money back. But then, provided the game's paused, it forgets what time the tick has happened. So when you load that save, it does the tick again, meaning you get twice the money for basically bulldozing the same property. And wha-bam, ladies and gentlemen, we've won the game. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. That was just under 10 minutes. The fastest game of Tropico anyone has ever done. Anyway, back to the main menu. Now, as fun as it would be to speedrun Tropico, I have other challenges which I'd like to do. My aim today, ladies and gentlemen, is to create a beautiful island in which just about everyone is in jail. And I want to see if, technically speaking and financially speaking, we can turn a profit by having an entire nation be just rammed into one tiny jail. Immediately, we're going to want to crank up that population limit to 10,000, trust me, as we're going to be needing a large population here to turn an even larger profit. So let's bam, jump into a brand new game of Tropico 6. Now, for this to actually be viable, we're going to need to start in modern times and start with a large starting population to give us a bit of an advantage. I'll also start us with 200,000, as you've seen, I have many ways of making money, so it doesn't really matter what we start with. Right, so I've just rolled ourselves a custom map of Tropico 6. It should be quite interesting to see what brave new world we'll be colonizing today. Now, immediately when we start the game, we have a glorious opportunity here to decide how our country works. This is our constitution, ladies and gentlemen, and it's something not to be taken too lightly. Immediately when it comes to voting rights, we're going to make it so that actually only wealthy citizens can vote, because trust me, there's not going to be too many of them. Now, when it comes to our armed forces, we're going to naturally have a militia, energy efficiency, and this is the most important one, when it comes to separation of powers, we don't want any. This means that citizen action costs are reduced by 90%. This is fantastic. Now, immediately you're going to notice that, wow, we are in a beautiful world. My goodness, this is majestic. But it's a beautiful world with some minor issues. And you will notice immediately that our biggest issue is the fact that we have slums everywhere. That's because we have a population of 200 people and absolutely nowhere to put them. Now, before I get started on my revolutionary new way of reforming the entire world, we need to get started on a couple of buildings. We need a chapel to make everyone happy, a grocery to sell food to our population, a clinic to stop everyone dying of poor health, a tavern so that the workers can spend all of their money, and now a library so that we can start researching things. Perfect. This is a great start. Now, our actual food production probably isn't actually going to be enough at the start of this game, so I am going to need to start placing down more ways of getting food, and honestly, corn plantations look like a great way to start. Splendid. 4 corn plantations. Now, what we've actually unlocked here is fantastic research from our library. Now, research isn't going to be that quick because we only have one library, but honestly, that's all we need. What you want to do is research penal colony. This is exceedingly important as it's going to increase our immigration rate, but also increase the chance of bringing criminals into this country. And actually, that's a good thing, ladies and gentlemen. After the penal colony, you're going to want to research media independence and emigration, as well as police station work modes. Trust me, it's going to all make sense eventually. Anyway, onwards with our fantastic production. Now, as you will immediately notice, we don't exactly have many places to store our very booming population. And as lovely as it would be to put them all in fantastic modern mansions, no, no, no. We're going to ram them all into tenements. Disgusting, horrific tenements, trust me. It's exactly what the people want. And there we go, penal colony has been researched, and immediately we can become a penal colony. Next up, we're going to want to set up a pirate cove, because these guys are going to allow us to do something rather unique with passers-by. Effectively, the pirate cove is offering aggressive adoption strategies. You know what, I think it's best I just show you what that means. You see, pirate coves can generate raid points. Said raid points can be used and invested in rescuing many people. Basically, the piratey boys are going to be sailing out into the ocean and then just finding various cruise liners, sinking them, and stealing everyone on board. Now, luckily on this island, we started very close to a huge supply of gold, so I suppose we could use that to get an economy up and running. But no, ladies and gentlemen, we're not playing that kind of Tropico. That's not where our money's going to be coming from. Instead, our money needs to naturally be coming from just classic spiff exploitations. So let's research the pharmaceutical company and whack down several of those. And now that they're there, we're going to demolish them, drop down a save, and load up that glorious save again. I'm sorry, but I'm going to be needing that pharmaceutical money to be investing in something relatively unique. And bam, we're now up to 277,000. Fantastic news. No, let's do that again. I could use some bonus money. And bam, 500,000 quite easily. Oh dear, what's this? Protesters? Why are they protesting fun happiness? Oh dear. Well, luckily I have a solution for this. We're going to need a barracks, ladies and gentlemen. So we're going to slap that down right next to El Presidente's magical
magical palace. Let's get that bad boy built. So, there are 14 people protesting about the lack of fun. Let us negotiate. We could bribe them. It's honestly not too much. Promise to raise fun happiness by 8, or just send the military in. Yeah, I think the latter's going to solve that much faster than I ever could. Right, go on, my lovely squad of armed men. Encourage those protesters to relocate. Fantastic stuff. Now, where is our money going to be coming from? Well, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to present to you the police station. Now, the police station is a relatively basic building. It's nothing too fancy, but what the police station does is it provides crime safety. So we're going to be placing this police station down next to our palace and sending some police out into the world. Now, we're going to be creating a corrupt police state, which is effectively going to be stealing people away. Now that we have our police station, we can start arresting people. But where do people go when they've been arrested? Well, we have two options here, the dungeon and the prison. I'm going to be demonstrating why both of them are fantastic. So we're going to be placing down our dungeon right here on the beachfront, and we'll also be whacking down a dungeon just next to it. Also, make sure to build an immigration office, because that's going to encourage more people to move in, and that's kind of exactly what we want. We want more people coming to the island. It doesn't matter that our island is actually not fun at all, and no one would want to live here. It's just that basically upon tricking them to arrive, they have no way of leaving. Anyway, what we've now created is a prison and a dungeon. Now, dungeons are quite good fun because their wage isn't particularly high, so we can reduce the wage of our lovely dungeon officers here to $4 per month, I'd like to add. And instead of actually having the dungeon try and reform inmates, we have convict labor. This decreases the efficiency of the building right down to 45%, but grants us an extra $25 for each inmate which is stored in here per month. Now, as inmates are being reformed at a ridiculously inefficient speed, you'd be surprised just how long we can keep them in custody. The same can be said for the mega prison, where we can reduce the wage down to 5%, and once again switch everything over to convict labor. Fantastic. And the prison can hold 32 prisoners, ladies and gentlemen. That's a lot of prisonage. Now, to keep costs down, I'm also going to be reducing the staff of all of the prisons down to literally just one person. Yeah, I mean, I don't want any efficiency, and equally, I don't want it to actually cost me anything to run. Look, this prison cost me $30 a month to run. This dungeon cost me $5 a month to run a dungeon. Fine. This is the joy of the dungeon. Okay, it costs $5 to run, but we get $25 per month that a civilian is in there. So what we need to do is find ourselves a lovely civilian. And the best way to find a civilian is you want to find one who is useless, which is exactly what we have here. We have Biel Ruse over here. He's 28, he's uneducated, he's poor, and he's unemployed. So what we can do is we can arrest him for $25. Remember, because of our previous constitution, it costs us 90% less to actually arrest someone and send them to prison. So that's exactly what we've done, and now he's over here in the dungeon. And you know what he's going to be doing there? Generating money, ladies and gentlemen. But of course, you might not know who your unemployed citizens are. Don't worry, hop into the population tab and find the uneducated people. Simply click on them, arrest more, keep arresting. Trust me, they can't contribute anything to the society anyway. And we're bam. We've managed to arrest all of these people, and you'll notice all of these lovely handcuffs above people's heads. These are the people who we have now stolen out of their fantastic accommodations, and we are simply dragging off straight to prison. It's perfect, trust me. The most important thing to remember, ladies and gentlemen, is it's actually perfectly legal. And perfect. More and more people are arriving in our prisons and dungeons as we speak. This is exactly as I wanted it. Now, you might be noticing that our population has already taken a pretty drastic fall down to 146. Now, this is exactly why you want to get onto your research screen and get emigration sorted as fast as possible. Oh dear, I've accidentally triggered a rebel uprising. Oh dear. Wow, there's a couple of people who are meant to be arrested in that rebel uprising. Right? My glorious armed soldiers. Fight those who simply want freedom. Where are they running? Are they running straight to the palace? Oh, bugger. Right, my men, chase them. Yes, they don't have proper guns. We should win this nonetheless. Glorious stuff. The rebels are getting defeated as they try and fight for freedom. Goodness, imagine how silly it would be to fight for freedom. Everyone knows freedom always loses in the end. So as you might remember, our dungeon over here genuinely only has one person inside it, Biel Ruse. Biel Ruse over here is generating $25 a month. It only costs us $5 a month to keep Biel Ruse here. So statistically, Biel Ruse is generating $20 a month. As a result, this building has already generated $222. The prison is relatively similar. Oh, and splendid, you'll notice that we completed the mission to rescue people from off the island, and immediately that's increased our population by about 20. And look at them here, all waltzing off, off. They are broke, they're unemployed, but hey, they're just arriving on our glorious island after being liberated from the clutches of the sea. Welcome. You're all unemployed, so hey, don't worry. We can just pause the game here and arrest all of you on the spot. Ah, trust me, you'll make more money in my dungeons than you could possibly actually working a real job. Oh, just look at the beeline of all the new arrested people just running straight into the dungeons. Come on, straight you go. You've just arrived. There you go. Just stand outside. Someone will let you in eventually. I mean, these are some great statistics. Our prison over here, it's generating $120 each month now. Good stuff. And we've only got 9 people in it. We can get it right the way up to 32. Now, another important building we're going to need is the commando garrison. We can slap that bad boy down anywhere. It makes absolutely no difference. Basically, we can use that to go and snipe some world wonders from around the world. And trust me, we're going to need some pretty wacky world wonders. Now, it's rather strange how actually no one seems to want to move into Tropico. It might have something to do with my 24% approval ratings, if I'm honest, but I mean, it's never stopped anyone from hanging out in Tropico in the past. But hey, we've finally researched immigration, and that's very important because it means in about 4 years' time, when I can actually redo my constitution, we're going to be able to establish a brand new kind of immigration. The best country on earth. This makes it physically impossible for citizens to emigrate, and that's exactly how we like it. Now, our fantastic dungeon over here has already generated 1,500 for us, which is fantastic. Ooh, make that 1,600. The prison as well is generating 7,900. That's a very tasty amount of money indeed. Oh, and another raid has been completed, so even more people are on our island. We're up to 202 because some people have just decided to leave on a boat. Oh dear. But hey, we finally researched our police station, and what that means is in our police station, we can switch around from serve and protect to live and let live. This means every apprehended criminal will add $50 to our Swiss bank account. Equally, it will mean the area around the police station will start reducing crime safety, which is very tasty. And remember, always add in some taverns, because taverns are the best way of encouraging people to commit crime. Oh, and we have some upcoming elections. No more votes, I'm afraid. We're not having elections. Sorry. Oh, and of course, we've had yet another rebel uprising. It's a bit of a shame, but honestly, it's no biggie, because we have quite a large military, as well as a glorious active army base. And once again, the guerrillas are going to lose. Well done to the glorious Tropico infantry fighting for the glory of the crown. Now, you might be wondering what we're doing with our commando garrison, and at the moment, absolutely nothing. They're to simply sit there and just look pretty and intimidate everyone. But soon, the commando garrison will have a very important purpose. Now, of course, we've researched National Day, which is fantastic, as that's going to allow us to decrease crime safety by 8, and also increase the efficiency of all cocktails and taverns. Lovely stuff. Oh dear, the gorillas set our prison on fire. Now, setting a prison on fire is not the best, because technically it does release all of the criminals back out into the real world, which means we have to track them back down again. And in fact, to stop such a thing from happening again, we're going to place multiple watchtowers on the corners of our glorious prison. Oh, I've jumped into the video when you least expected me. Bam, that's right. You definitely weren't expecting a surprise spiff to suddenly appear and demand you to go refill your cup of tea. I hope you're nice and relaxed, but you know how you'd be more relaxed with a cup of tea. Not just any tea, Yorkshire tea, in not just any mug, a Spiffco approved mug. That's right, we actually have them. I've probably bought about 70% of them. Just look at how majestic they are. Some say drinking out of it will stop El Presidente immediately exiling you to France. I mean, who'd want to end up in France? I can imagine that my entire French viewership is gone. But then again, didn't really have one. So it's all okay. Oh dear, if you're still here, please say hi. But anyway, I'm here to also offer you a limited time deal. That's right, if you like this video, El Presidente promises that he won't throw your family into prison for the next 10 minutes. Isn't that a great deal, ladies and gentlemen? Ah, remember, vote El Presidente. Let's get back into that video. Ah, and finally, the Constitution can now be fixed. So yes, let us jump into the Constitution and set our emigration policy to no one is allowed to emigrate. Finally, media independence. This is very important. We need sponsored content. This increases the revenue of all media buildings by 100%. It's fantastic. You want it. It's amazing. Bam. Confirm changes. Lovely stuff. Now, why is the media building so important? Well, basically, we can now build ourselves glorious radio stations, and that's exactly what we're going to do. So, well, bam, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves the brand new radio station. It's a unique building which has a large area of effect. As you can see, one radio station is enough to cover literally everything on the entire island. Now, what we're going to do is place this radio station down next to our glorious prisons, and don't worry, it's going to make a lot of sense soon. So, with our brand new constitution, basically no one can actually leave the island, and as a result, that means means all of our missions, which are going to be stealing people, yep, like say right here, are going to be resulting in very large populations just waltzing onto the island. Look at all of our brand new visitors. From Germany, who are broke, welcome to the prison, my friend. Someone from Russia who's broke, prison. France who's broke, more prison. Prison for everyone. It's fantastic. You just enter a brand new island, but no, I'm afraid it's prison time. Now the raids are a fantastic way because roughly every single raid we gain an extra 20 or so people, which is very effective. So bam, arrest, arrest, arrest. Welcome to our fantastic island. Oh goodness, look at all of the arrests. It's fantastic. Now, one of the best things about slums is that whilst many people think that they're bad because they generate crime, whilst that's true, you have to remember that crime is fantastic because crime is effectively people that just get arrested for free. Look at all of these people. I didn't have to manually arrest them. These are just actual criminals. Same for our dungeon over here. Speaking of our dungeon, it's generated 5 grand. Look at the thing. It's only got 8 people in here. The prison, however, is doing great. That thing's generated 14 grand over its lifetime. Anyway, we've got our radio station up and running. Why is the radio station important? Well, that's because we have public paid service advertisements. These mean we get $8 for each citizen employed in the vicinity of the radio station every time they go to work. This is very important. It's going to be generating a ridiculously large amount of money. Also, remember that we doubled it, meaning we actually get $16 every time an advertisement is made. So even though for some reason this building doesn't actually have electricity, meaning it's operating at 0% efficiency, we're still making a lot of money because you don't actually need electricity to get it up and running. Anyway, we've got it up and running now. How's the money coming along? Well, it's coming very nicely, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at it just tick up. It's free money. You want to know the best thing about the radio station? You can just make more of them. How should they cost? They're only like 2,400. So provided this building makes 2,400, it's turned a profit and it doesn't even need electricity. And also it increases liberty, which makes people happy. I know, it's completely and utterly wild. And we're bam. We now have free radio stations all up and running, all generating money. So how's our prison doing? Well, it's now got 24 inmates, and as a result, yes, we generate 540 from them per month, and it's generated 25,000 in total. It's more than paid for itself, because prisons, they only cost 12,000. You know what this calls for? A second prison. That's right, we're going to slap down a second prison over here, where we're hopefully going to be expanding our population a bit. Oh dear, we're having yet another rebel uprising. Well, it's kind of okay, because at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, we literally have an entire tank here. I'm sorry, but puny rebels versus entire tank, the tank always wins. Now, admittedly, we are going to lose a distinctive quantity of our population in literally a cloud of... What even is this? This is fighting. In a cloud of smoke, it's all gonna go. Because, you know, we have to defend the palace somehow. And of course we did. But all that matters is that thankfully the prison was not harmed. Very good news. Anyway, we need to actually clean up some more of these unemployed citizens. Who have we got? 3 people unemployed. Bam. Arrest, arrest, and arrest. As well as you. Arrest and arrest. Fantastic stuff. Now you might be wondering, how can we make even more money off of everyone who we've got in jail? Well, luckily, this is where the courthouse comes in. That's right, it's literally a building which just makes money off of people in prison. It doesn't matter where we put these, so we're literally going to put it right in the middle of nowhere. Fantastic. Now, if you're wondering who else to actually arrest who isn't unemployed or uneducated, don't worry. Simply go for special citizens and simply find yourselves criminals. Now, luckily, all of our criminals are in prison, which is fantastic. But after the criminals, find yourselves just regular rebels living in society. Like this person who works at an oil well. Arrest. And this person who works in a tavern. Probably arrest. Basically, the more people we arrest, the better. In a purely financial sense, of course. And I also like to not discriminate. I'm arresting nuns, firemen, actual army officers, policemen. Everyone can get arrested. It only cost me $25 to throw you in there. But once you're in there, trust me, you make a lot of money for someone who isn't you. Anyway, fantastic. I think that's a good 5% of the actual rebel faction just arrested in one immediate go. Now, how's that courthouse of mine doing? Well, it's up and running, and luckily it's looking into criminal law. Now, what does that mean? Well, that means each month it is generating $236 just because we have some blokes in a prison somewhere. It's only going to cost us around about $34 a month to keep it running, but whilst it's up and running, it just makes money. Ah, fantastic. A courthouse working exactly as intended. It's going to be making a lot of happy profit soon. Oh yes, our prisons are doing very well. Look at that. This prison has made 43,000 over its entire lifetime. You know what? I found another fantastic way which is going to generate crime. Bam. It's the right to arms. We're going to let everyone carry a gun. It's fantastic. What does it mean? Crime safety goes down. That's exactly what we want. Oh, once again, the game wants to have us do elections. Well, we're not going to be doing any of that, because only 7% of the population is actually going to approve me, so, no. No elections, please. You know what? I'm going to speed up some time until our population has grown a little bit more, and then I'll demonstrate to you how we're going to be using the radio stations and prisons to generate a silly amount of money. Right, bam. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our island. It's changed a fair bit since we were last here. The amount of prisons has increased. We have this prison here, which is almost completely full. We have this prison here, which isn't actually too busy at the moment, but you'll notice there are a ridiculously large amount of people running around our lands trying to find a brand new prison to go to. We have completely almost filled this prison. This prison's growing pretty nicely, and so is this one. In total, I think we have roughly a few hundred prisoners on our island, and as a result, our courthouse... Oh, well, they would be making money if they weren't accidentally just set on fire. Well, bugger. Oh dear, everything's on fire. Well, alas, it matters little, because our courthouse generates a nice amount of money each month. But where else does our strange surplus money come from? Well, of course, the newspaper here, the Penny Saver, which has generated 86,000 over the years by simply selling newspapers for profit. Oh, and then there's, of course, our radio station, which has generated a nice 30,000 from literally just shouting at everyone nearby whenever they work, as well as offices, which are relatively unique. These offices basically generate $2 per each employed citizen across Tropico. Now, this is a very nice way of making a very large amount of money, because you can just build offices and more offices and more offices, and your money just goes up and up and up. It's especially spicy when you can just buy a bunch of coconut harvesters and pay said coconut harvesters literally $3. When you attach two offices to that, that means each coconut harvester just generates $1 per month for just simply existing. They don't even have to do any work. So we have, say, Sergio Romero over here, who simply works in Tropico. As we have three offices up and running, we generate $6 just for him existing and working a job. We only pay him $3. In actuality, we make slightly more than that, because we've also made our lovely nation a tax haven, which increases all office earnings by 25%. So yes, things are looking very spicy. Everyone's happy, everyone's excited, and most importantly, we're making a lot of money. Just look at our strange income. We've gained 13,000 from convict labor. It makes no sense. Absolutely no sense. Our offices and offshore offices, they also make a very nice amount of money. It's just created a bit of a strange situation, if I'm honest, ladies and gentlemen. You don't actually need or want people to work real jobs. Just simply throw them down into random jobs and pay them pathetic wages. Take, say, our glorious guard tower over here. Anyone's willing to work a guard tower job, we'll pay them $4 and our office will immediately turn a profit on it. It's absolutely fantastic and has no possible negatives. Some could say it's absolutely perfectly balanced. Naturally, you know what? Seeing as we have so much money, let me just quickly relocate the palace, as we don't want it anywhere near the peasants, and instead live a life of luxury over here on my private island. Ah, yes, glorious. Now we just need to make sure no one can actually invade it. Right, I want watchtowers literally everywhere. I want watchtowers for looking over my existing watchtowers to make me feel more safe. I want security checkpoints all the way along the road. Go on, no one's allowed to get close. I also want an entire fort for no particular reason other than it's gonna look great. Oh, and also slap down the Eiffel Tower. Why not? I want that outside. Why is the Eiffel Tower so good? Well, we can strap satellites to the top of it, which make our radio stations even more powerful. Now the range of the radio station is the entire island because of the Eiffel Tower. Trust me, it makes perfect sense. Right, bam, let's get these watchtowers up and running. We must defend El Presidente at all costs. Bam, perfect, we've done it. We've found a place to protect El Presidente. Finally, no one will be able to steal his magnificent glory. He is safe from the outside world. I mean, actually, the one place we're not safe from is the skies. So let's quickly build a aircraft carrier. I want that just parked just straight outside. Oh my goodness, this is a fantastic idea. We can have a drone, which is literally set to opposition is reason enough, meaning we send out a drone which will just vaporize any citizen who has a lower approval rating of us than 20%. Honestly, this seems like a fantastic idea. Fantastic, we've got it up and running. Glorious drone system. Oh, hang on, so there's a protest going on here. Protest, reason, faith, happiness. Right, let's negotiate. Military time, come on, send in the liquidation drones. Yes, liquidation drones. Wow, actually, look at them go. Heck, we've even got a fighter jet. Who knows where that's going, but I am interested by the liquidation drone. All right, little drone, where are you flying to? I mean, some would say that this technically is a human rights violation, but I mean, at the end of the day, provided we classify that only El Presidente is a human being, it's perfectly legal. Wait, hang on a second. Are we sending a helicopter to just vaporize a single workman or a shack? Where is this helicopter going? Oh, it's done it. It just literally flew out here and just vaporized someone on the streets and is now flying all the way back. What kind of a wild setup is this? Our courthouse is also doing great, by the way. $576 per month just for existing. Offices as well do about $700 a month just for existing. This is fantastic ways of making money. Now, ultimately, ladies and gentlemen, all good things must ultimately come to an end. And I'm afraid that's enough Tropico for one day. I hope you have enjoyed looking at a relatively unique spin of Tropico, in which we basically decided to generate money in a way which doesn't particularly make sense. A game which thrives itself on an economy based on exports of copious quantities of bananas, we instead decided to imprison a population in order to generate money. And by all means, it is exceedingly profitable. Prisoners are exceedingly powerful, and it would be absolutely fantastic if someone modded in a button which would literally just allow me to arrest on sight every single unemployed person. That would be fantastic. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, if you have indeed enjoyed this video, feel free to give the video a like, as it massively does help me out. Thank you very much, and I hope you have an absolutely lovely day. As always, a massive thank you to each and every one of these lovely patrons who you see on screen. Their majestic patronage allows me to create these very strange videos. A thank you very much. Anyway, if you're wondering what video to watch next, look no further than this one on screen now. It's been hand chosen by myself to be absolutely perfect for you. Have an absolutely lovely day, and I'll see each and every one of you in the next one. And sadly, it's goodbye for now.